I'm neen on bad ala avam se ahi id ko ahi id ko avo dand shuma Hai mani nan bad alaha ava amse ahi dko.
This is July 19th of 2014. We are at the campus of Dharmaram Vidya Kshetram. We just finished a day program on the Sarek heritage, and we are privileged to have Sebastian Manacheri. He attended the seminar and he made some very good interventions. And your name Manacheri is so special because Justin Manacheri was highly involved in the preparation of the notation, music notation of the Syriac Solemn High Mass. Are you related?
We are from the same family. Of course, this Manacheri family is very widely scattered actually. There is the Trichur Manacheri, the MP Paul belongs. And actually, I am, both of us are from Paravur. I am basically Valvoli Manacheri and he is from Karimalur. But we are related. Same family.
So tell me about your association with the Sarek tradition.
Well, first of all, I would like to compliment you for the very enlightening talk, and also you could see, saw the seeds of some very useful trends which we should follow. We have to really be proud of our heritage, and we should try to hand over it to the next generation. I'm afraid somewhere we have failed, maybe because of our anxiety, eagerness to make it more comprehensible to the people of God. We have translated everything into local language, Malayalam. That's all very good. But at the same time, the heritage is something which we should preserve with great pride and with great care. One example I give, the people, the CMI congregation, the logo, hardly anyone knew. The younger generation, because that's something great. It shows the zeal of the congregation.
I have the privilege of belonging to the religious congregation that continues to print its motto in the Syriac language on its official letterhead. I'm just curious. And the CMI congregation, the motto. Let me see if the younger generation is understanding that. What is our motto? Okay. That is a shame for us. I have been very zealous of the Lord, my mighty God.
Probably we have forgotten that. I am burning with the zeal of the Lord of hosts. Methan Dennis Alaha Maria Alaha Ilsana.
Now, how are you able to say those words? What is your background? Do you know that Syriac text?
Yes. Before that, let me tell you, I am a very humble but very passionate lover of languages. Languages can really teach us, give us insights which we can get directly instead of depending on what so-and-so said, what so-and-so has defined, etc. Now, you are mentioning, you are giving some examples like Ruha.
In every language, there are words that define themselves by their sounds. The sound of the word itself is its meaning. Such words emerge out of the communal wisdom of the speakers of a language. Usually, these words are understood in exactly the same way by the speakers of the same language across the board. One such example from the Aramaic lexicon is the word Ruh. which literally means breath. The utterance of this word requires a special use of air and energy that explicates the meaning. Ruh is pre-language, even pre-word. It is pre-om. Ruh is the raw material with which words and meanings are constructed. In the beginning was the Ruh. The Ruh was with God, and Ruh was God. Don't blame me, I just made that.
It is amazing that in Quran, in the Arabic actually, about Jesus Christ, although they don't accept him as the Son of God, he is a prophet par excellence. And only about Jesus there is this phrase, Ruh Allah.
Oh, wow.
The spirit of the God.
Yeah.
And languages will really cut down the barriers. When I was a small child, being very orthodox type of, being born in a very orthodox family, I would wonder why these people are calling God Devam as Allah, Allah. And this is prejudice.
Yeah.
Without knowing what they mean.
Yeah.
I have prejudged. This is something wrong, etc. But now, after learning a little bit of Arabic, I understood, and after learning Aramaic or Syriac, Allah is the same as Allah. And we are giving the same name, we are praising the same Lord. Why should we have this kind of difference and prejudices?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I have learned Syriac. Okay. I'm very proud of that.
Yeah, yeah.
And I feel very happy when the original hymns, hymns are sung in the original Syriac or Aramaic forms, etc.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Those are very touching. And you mentioned about Father Justin.
Yes.
Menachery.
Yeah.
I was very much privileged that I could, right from childhood, I could hear the choir, which was trained and taught by Justin Menachery.
Uh-huh.
At Kunama, St. Joseph's Monastery.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Three outstanding members, Lonapan Bhagavatam,
uh-huh,
a very highly respected person, man of very little means, I should say. Still, he preserved that, actually. Unfortunately, he is no more with us.
Okay.
He would have been a treasure of information for you.
Uh-huh.
Because he knows some of the rarest tunes of Uwalara,
uh-huh,
or the equivalent,
right,
of Peace Upon Earth,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
that, that,
yeah,
hymns and all.
Uh-huh.
And I could hear that right from the beginning,
yeah,
actually.
Can you recall some of those melodies by chance?
It's a solemn thing, actually.
Yes.
I mean, certain solemn occasions.
Uh-huh.
Often it's very difficult, but
okay.
Actually, interestingly, you know, we used to think that these are very slow. There were some adivali lines also.
Yeah.
I am sure you recollect this Pallandashane,
yeah,
one particular
one.
Pallandashane nakare ule nesgodmayo sel rase varya seke Ati keta te talabadna hadta hai manusa shamelia hasirus regshai pagera
Reg Shai Pagera, Reg Shai Pagera, Reg Shai Pagera. It was a repetition of the same way.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I just recollected.
Wow, wow, wow. Interesting.
Because this was taught by Lorpan Ashan.
Uh-huh.
I mean, we were very privileged. He taught us so many of these tunes. Uh-huh. Of course, you know, somehow we should try to preserve most
yes.
of them.
Actually. Yes, yes, yeah. yes. Yeah. Sebastian, last time when we met, you mentioned the melody of Barak Maar.
Yeah.
Could you please sing that?
Well, I remember it very vividly because, you know, it gave an atmosphere. Because it was leading, you know, it's a kind of conducive to the mystery that's going to be. So the priest, though people could not understand the verbatim meaning of that, but it really created the mood that we are, now we have to get ready for that sacred day. Whatever little I can recall.
Yeah, please.
Barak Maar, Barak Maar, Barak Maar. Makarwalan Maranwalahan Brahmano Sad Taibuse Kadla Shavena Bashrara Kadla Shavena കർത്താവെ ഞങ്ങൾ അയോഗ്യരാകുന്നു, തീർത്ഥം അയോഗ്യരാകുന്നു, ഞങ്ങളെ ആശീർവദിച്ചാലും.
ആൻഡ്
ദെൻ ദി സോളം ഹൗ ദക്തം യൗമാദ ഒരു സോളം. ബിഫോർ ദാറ്റ് സംഹൗ ഇറ്റ് മെൽറ്റഡ് ഇൻ ടു ദാറ്റ് പർട്ടിക്കുലർ സേക്രഡ് സോളം ഒക്കേഷൻ.
കുഡ് യു റിമെമ്പർ ദാറ്റ് സോങ് വിതൗട്ട് ലുക്കിംഗ് അറ്റ് ദി ടെക്സ്റ്റ്? ഹൗ കം ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ingrained in your brain? When did you sing it last time?
Actually, it must have been long back, 63, 64, 65. I'm not boasting myself. If I read something with real love and passion, it gets ingrained in my mind and heart. Okay, that's true with Malayalam poems. So it's the same with the hymns, Syriac hymns actually. And I picture how the priest says that I am unworthy. I am truly unworthy, Bashrara, Bashrara, in truth, truly I am not worthy of this one. With that humility, he really performs or conducts that great...
So you mean to say that that melody is so, so good to convey that sense
absolutely.
Of unworthiness?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, though we don't sing it that often, it is not heard. Another two lines which I remember. After the Oshana, there was, in the olden days, there was a little bit of magic also, you know, as usual, you know. There were three times knocking at the Anavadil.
You are talking about Palm Sunday.
Palm Sunday, I'm sorry, you know, the Palm Sunday. Then the third knocking, the doors automatically opened. And we think, oh, this is real divine intervention. Although one of the choir members removed the... The moment we enter, the choir, without instrument, sings the commandment which Jesus Christ taught, actually. Though we didn't follow the meanings in those days, it really conveyed this new commandment is being given. I mean, I could get the feel, actually. This is Pugdan Handes Yahev Naluhon Raham Lahdade Raham Lahdade. A new commandment I am giving you. Love each other, love one another. Raham lahadade, raham lahadade. And then the choir repeats so many of those things. Actually, it's only once a year it is sung. But it was so touching.
Yeah.
I mean, it is still ingrained in my mind and heart.
Yeah.
I don't know. As I told you, I am very passionate about the languages. Because languages really give, you know, like we mentioned a while ago about the room. And you also mentioned poets, I believe, you know, so also inspired by Holy Spirit, irrespective of Hindu or Muslim. If Ayalar did that, there is a divine intervention in that, divine inspiration.
An example from the lyrics of a Malayalam movie song by a famous lyricist and poet might support the argument. Sri Vayalar Ramavarma wrote a Christian prayer song for the film Magane Ninakku Vendi. The song starts with a minor doxology. Bhavaikin putrenun parishuddharuhaikin studiyayirikkete eppolum studiyayirikkete. Sri Vayalar, a Hindu, was well versed in the Christian folklore of Kerala. His more famous colleague, Sri Yeshudas, the playback singer, is a Catholic. The film was released in 1971, 9 years after the Siramanavar Church translated the liturgy into Malayalam. The minor doxology by that time was already on the lips of every Catholic in Kerala as Pidavanam Putranam Parishuddhaatmavana Stuthi. Instead of following the popular version, Sri Vayalar decided to retain the Aramaic word Ruha. Both words Parishuddhaatmava and Parishuddhaaruvi would have been a perfect fit to the melody. Bhavaikim putrenum Parishuddhaatmavanam would have been fine. Parishuddhaaruvikim would have been fine. Vayalar knew, however, that both Atmava and Arubi had accumulated different connotations and might detract the listeners from the sense of the original Aramaic word Ruha. He knew that words carried not only particular meanings but also collective memories of the speakers of the language. In retrospect, one can really appreciate the wisdom of Sri Vayalar Ramavarma, a Hindu.
The same thing with the Hindi lyricist. When they have to convey the very inexplicable concept or term, they use Urdu, which is very close to Aramaic or
Arabic
actually. Now, Ruh is very often used actually, in a world of very touching film, Khamoshi, Silence. There is a nice song which conveys, love should not be given any name, the pure love. Don't spoil that experience by giving names. This is the name that's on it. And it says, Sirf ehsaas hai, this is an experience. A Ruh se, this spirit, sir. It is spirit, as I mentioned there. Translator is a traitor.
Spirit
is not the word.
Right.
That breath that comes to you is a mehsoos karo. Experience that and keep quiet. That's all. I mean,
true.
Don't ever explain to them.
Right.
And you know, this is all poets actually. A great poet has said, don't ever explain a good poem. It is to be experienced.
Right.
Poem should not mean it should be.
Yes.
That's what I talk about, the profound words of Aramaic.
Yes.
Ruh should always remain Ruh.
Yeah.
Either Alma or Lingle. And that's why I gave a parallel example. T.S. Eliot is considered to be the, at least one of the best poets. He is considered the prophet of modern civilization, 20th century. And that poem, hardly known as understood. Some say that's because of that only he got Nobel Prize. Nobody understood. So very difficult, you know, Greek mythology, Aramaic mythology, and full of biblical, this thing, washing of the feet. And he say, in the modern, this thing, he washed the feet with the beer, you know. Juxtaposition. Finally, in order to give a suitable climax, he borrowed myths from Indian heritage. And he ends the poem in a silent, peaceful note. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Wow.
The most familiar example from India is the Sanskrit term Shanti. Shanti. The very utterance of the word creates the effect. And it is understood by the listener instantly. Interpretations are unnecessary.
That's really remarkable. It should be a lesson for all of us.
Yes.
When you have to really conclude something which is profound,
yes,
don't give approximation.
Yes.
Give the original. People will feel it. People will, no need to explain actually. Yes. It will be experienced actually. Yes.
Thank you, because I am going to use your example.
Thank you so much.
Can you sing a few more melodies? Can you recall something?
Well, you know, how many tunes are you familiar with I Believe in God? That
Bahaimanin?
Sing one.
I cannot even remember one.
My goodness.
Yeah.
That gives me confidence.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
When you say.
Go ahead.
One solemn tune will it. Bahaimanin anbad alaha. Avamse Ahi Idko Ahi Idko Avodandashumaya. It goes on to there. Then there is the other
melody is the same now?
I don't know. I mean,
this is, I believe, this
I believe
is
in God. The priest begins, I'm Haimni in Bahadalaha. Bahadalaha in one God.
Yes.
You know? So, the Avada, this one who is the creator of Almighty, with the seen and visible and invisible.
Very majestic.
Yeah, too. Very majestic. Haimni in Bahadalaha. That's the second tune.
Oh, great, great. Equally majestic.
Yeah, yeah. It's a solemn, I mean, thing.
That's any other?
I really like that translation, Cheriyavarum Valiyavarum. You know, in that
Urbanele.
Cheriyavarellam and original. And original, you know that actually.
Now sing it.
Kathuvasikkunne. And the original tune is Sore Amrarve Asheval Saura Kolaho Nanide. Vaikyanta Shvita Shuhat Kimenno.
Beautiful. Now coming back to the Latin, Syriac translations of Latin chants, any melodies from the Kurieleison litany section?
Realization there were, our times there were at least 20-25 tunes actually. Only thing, Kurie Laison, Kurie Laison, Kurie Laison. That's no, one.
Kurie Laison, Kurie Laison,
Kurie Laison. This is the same there. It doesn't.
That's all right. Any other melody that.
You remember Wednesdays we used to sing hymn for
Slam Lake Maria?
Slam Lake Maria.
Oh, can you recall that?
Words I don't know. That before that actually. Now another profound word which we should preserve is Slama.
Yeah.
Slama is a salam. In Arabic it is salam. Salam alaikum.
Yeah.
People will get worried, thrown at you. What is this people,
It's
the most beautiful a pacifying greeting I have ever heard. Hello, hi, this is our say. Assalamu alaikum, they say, repeat it to her. Assalamu alaikum, peace be with you. Slama amaho, it's the same thing.
So,
Slam le means hail thee. Slam le. Sorry, words.
Sing the melody.
Wasi Musa metanahina la 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 la. This I don't have the words. Sorry.
Very nice.
I remember Father Crispin, who was a great painter.
Yes, painter.
Oh, wonderful.
Yes.
Terrific. He gets into the mood.
Yeah.
And that time he doesn't want to be disturbed.
Yeah.
He will yell at you if you disturb him. He loses his temper. Once he gets the inspiration, he will go and then come back and then. While going, there used to be some parrot in the monastery. He will try to take, Slam le Maria. Slam le Maria.
Do you have any recollection of Holy Thursday, the service at night?
Washing of the feet, etc. as someone rightly mentioned, the church service used to be in the morning.
Mm.
All right, and there is, different kinds of, we move from one altar to the other.
Uh-huh.
And evening, it is really totally family affair, you know. Uh-huh. I mean, in a mood of sanctified mood, actually.
Uh-huh.
The father, you know, will prepare the coconut, the same land for the kind of pale.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, with great reverence and solemnity, he would give according to the seniority in the eldest first, and the last will be the youngest, you know. So, but church service at the moment, I don't know. But the Friday, I'm sure you don't know. In Janame Chulga, what I have done.
Yes, yes, yes.
Ammana. Ammana Enjaname, my people. So that is where, when the bitter juice is served to everybody.
The bitter concoction?
Yes, concoction. That time this is sung actually.
Can you recall some more melodies?
But this one, all saubhagyangalum mudichiru nilkunna ee sabhayil ningale njangale angaye njangal svilikkum
illa
vallappa ikkala horudrarike utaivasa delvasa drama screen love and shambhal etam kallal tamaliya skolu dranin kol tuvin Datum mara varo yad kol Abhava uraru ad kudusha Lalmi
How is Amen?
Amen Lagumara Dukalla Pageran Vattu Paro Katava Benavshasan Ashinge Dagiya Isidai Veskar Kesalla Madhubha Maria Alagu Marad Kola Amaude The rest is same actually, as the priest of That is
wow,
the beginning.
This is amazing. Really amazing that he can remember the melody and the text.
Yeah, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world.
Uh-huh.
Emare Dala Aho Desha Ke Ati Se Dalma Hasal and Maran. Pinne ente sahodare Vishnu Kurbana Sirikkan Sabha Nammale Kshanikkunnu ennullavaru. Ahai Kambel Pagare Daura Amrayetam Vestau Kase Baimanusa Besmalkusa.
This melody sounds very similar to the one you mentioned on Palm Sunday.
Some of the I think see, some solemn tunes are very common in most of the things.
Right.
For Christmas, we sing one tune, and that is used in the solemn high mass also. For example, today, I think before the communion, there is asking forgiveness, etc.
Rahami Shukana Inala Hamare Kol Marpena. That's the same tune used for all solemn occasions.
I see.
You're talking about the feast of Blessed Mary. Similarly, for sacred arts,
Lamba Halia Dishomarin.
I think somewhere.
It is about the, so it was a translation from a Latin chant?
It is from Latin chant. Then you are asking about Kuriyal Aiso now.
Yeah.
Is it litany or that one?
Litany.
Kuriyal Aiso Christe Laiso Laiso Mishihash Main Mishiha Kambel Bausan Alahaud Vashmaya Kambel Bausan Trisayusagandistad Alaha Kambel Bausan.
Then the litany of either Blessed Mary or of the, I think, All Saints also.
All Saints, it's Sacred Heart.
Sacred Heart also. It's, and there is Malayalam, very very old song, you know. Litany.
Puloga Pabangale Agave Hanikyumna Ega Deva Kunyadam Ishoida Tirudayame Nyangale Trikkan Parkename Asmadiyangalaya Akrama Pravartiyal Bhasmam Bol Pedinyadam Ishoida Tirudayame Nyangale Trikkan Parkename.
Have you heard of this one?
No.
And you look at the Asmadiyangalaya, Sanskrit, Asmadiyangalaya, Akrama Pravartiyal, Bhasmam Bol Pedin.
Do the Akshara Prasa.
No, yeah, the Bhangar of the Nata.
It's
remarkable. Actually, I prepared that three different tunes of this thing, but unfortunately, it got totally erased. My son recorded that one. Sometime later, I will.
So let us show this on camera.
The book
that you're holding is very important. In the beginning of our conversation, we mentioned Justin Menacheri.
Yes,
he assisted in preparing the Syriac Malayalam hymnal.
Yeah, the only apprehension I have about this, Father Saldana, being a priest who belonged to the Latin rite, it's not quite possible that he could collect all these original tunes, melodies of Syriac songs. Probably one who had a profound mastery in all this notation was Father Justin Menacheri. And it is really mysterious how the, nowhere his name is mentioned.
His name is not mentioned.
Not mentioned anywhere.
But I have heard other people, CMI older priests, mentioning Justin Menacheri's name.
Yes.
Especially priests who lived at Alua Monastery.
Yeah, yes.
So that's how I came to know about it.
Yeah, yeah.
And when I read the preface, I was shocked that his name is
not mentioned actually.
It was he and Father Justin of our congregation who wrote first and published a book containing the notes of our traditional song.
And I have heard it from Father Zeno Vidayathil, because he happens to come from that area,
Kovarpally.
A couple of others, and as I told you,
My mother used to tell me about his training, the training he imparted to the choir at St. Joseph's Monastery.
Meaning Justin Menachin.
At Kunamau. There was a wonderful choir who was very much sought after in those days, you know. Now, just like this orchestra goes to so many places, you know. They were going to different churches, parishes for solemn mass because that had a wonderful team. Matthew Gachapuli, so sonorous voice actually. And I mean, I don't think he had any formal training in music, but the training which was imparted by Father Justin Menachery, and who was ably assisted by this Bhagavatar, Lonapan
Father. Now, Justin Menachery was a priest at that time.
Yes.
In the CMI.
In the CMI, very much. Yes. And then later, of course, unfortunately, he left the congregation. What I heard actually settled down in Madras. That's where what I have heard from my mother. But the Kunamau Monastery had a very famous, very popular choir who would sing all these songs. That's what I said. Some of the tunes of Uvalara, others have never heard that, which is the most solemn actually. I remember our team coming from SH province, you know, when we came to Dharmaram. That time we had the solemn high mass in Suryakandu. So we were so happy and proud to share with them, you know. This is the most solemn thing where, you know, and that's where, I'm sorry I cannot recollect that, but some of the little bit, very rhythmic there. So, for example, first part of Valera will start in a very solemn note. And when it comes, the Lord, holy, thou art alone, most powerful. Kandisha abalaho da ahalsana abalaho da lamayosa abalaho da maude nalla. That kind of with very rhythmic and
vibrant,
very vibrant. The entire church used to get that kind of spirit actually, though they didn't know the meaning of it.
There was a kind of enthusiasm.
So among the laity, the congregation also. And now, you know, and surprisingly, the congregation would join them, though not in the days, like Kandisha Alahai, everybody knew. There is a difference in the pronunciation in different ways, some as you were mentioning. I think the Malangara people were Orthodox. Kandisha. Kandisha. That's what. Everybody could sing that. Kandisha.
So, seven songs people congregation.
And I mean, people would join that because these are very easy to pick up. That's one great thing about these melodies. People could easily follow. The congregation could do it. One aberration which has, to me, has happened after we have switched over to Malayalam. Initially, there was so much of collective participation. Like any song, Father Abel, I think Father Abel did most of the job actually beautifully. And I think I should mention at this time, when he passed away, I wrote a note in one of the Saudi Arabian newspapers.
Yes. Do you have a copy of that?
Right now I don't have, but maybe I can. I mean,
can you trace
it's a, they have most popular one is Arabic news, Arab news.
Yeah.
So there is a Malayalam version of that, Malayalam. So when I wrote, actually, I didn't mention about that he's a priest and that, but he was a poet par excellence, no doubt about it.
Yes.
Because I very vividly remember, and I mentioned it in that letter also, G. Shankara Kurupa once praised him. This was marvelous. Mangiyorandi velichathil chendi poloru malaka. This kind of simile, Mangiyorandi velichathil chendi poloru malaka. And it is actually something like Thomas Gray's elegy written in the country churchyard. Mm-hmm. Everything is, a dark image is coming out.
Mm-hmm.
And there you can't say like the sun or the moon.
Yeah.
Torch, Chandi Bolarumala. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, I remember, I don't know whether you remember, in our younger days, there was no electricity. People yes. go,
Oh. The Chandi Bolaru Malaha comes from that?
Chandi Bolaru Malaha, you know, in the total surrounding darkness, there appears a bright torch actually. In order to explain that, so a very common, very popular image was brought out by him. So Jishankar Gurupa really praised him very much, when he translated that actually. It's the translation of the Sri Gurna. So, there was a lot of flaw in his poem.
Yes.
The aberration I mentioned, later what happened, the choir somehow took over certain thing. And I don't know, to me, when I used to come from outside, I was in Rajasthan, whenever I come for holidays, when I go to the mass, I found typical Yeshudas and Janaki type of one or two taking the mic and, they are trying to shine in the vision, but without much of congregational participation. I think this is one point we should try to remember, that all should participate. So if you choose the most difficult type of tunes, etc., it may be difficult.
Right.
I have seen today, when I come from abroad, only for holidays, almost everyone sings, hums this tune, because I don't know, somehow they, because again it shows the root, somehow it is the subconscious. They said that is really beautiful. I'm not talking from your point of view. The common man, he says that's really wonderful, very simple, but what a nice tune. Everybody sings that tune. So that has to be, I think this is a combination of all those things, bringing back our traditional thing and making it more common man friendly rather than professional, highly professional.
Right. Yes, yes.
So, really, it was wonderful.
Okay, thank you, and thank you for your time, for coming far away.
Because I thoroughly enjoyed sitting through your presentation.
Yeah.
Very well done, and I'm sure God's blessings will be in abundance with you
thank you.
Your project.
Whatever little.
I'll definitely do that.
Thank you. Let us conclude it with your reciting the Our Father in Syriac.
I would request you to join me actually.
Let me listen to
Where I get stuck.
Avundvashmaya
Nishkandasma Tese Malkusa Nehve Seviyana. I can adab in short and Ula Tayan in Lesiona Elapasan Minbisha. Kulattayalil nesiyona ellapasan minbisha metol lesnasalein taivu se sharirais mariyaulalam.
Where did that come from?
That is actually a Tadevum, end of Tadevum.
Oh, wow.
End of Tadevum.
Yes. Do you remember the first part of Tadevum?
La ha la ha mshabayinan la humariya Laha Laha.
Then it is the same melody for the rest?
Yeah, the rest of them.
And please conclude it in the end.
Kulattayalil nesiyona ellapasan minbisha metol lesnasalein taibu se Shari Rais Maria Ulalam.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.